Hello everyone, welcome to session 37 of security testing video series. In this session, I am going to walk you through the list of SQL basics that you have to learn for understanding this SQL injection vulnerability. So let's get started. In the next session, guys, I am going to explain this SQL injection vulnerability in detail. But before moving to the next session, you should have some knowledge, guys, okay? You should have some basic knowledge of this SQL. Without having the SQL basic knowledge, we cannot understand SQL injection. So let me first explain what is this SQL. Then I'll list down or walk you through the list of SQL basics that you have to learn before moving to the next session. So what is SQL then? SQL stands for, okay, what is SQL? SQL stands for Structured Query Language. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. Fine. Using this SQL, that is Structured Query Language, we can perform a lot of operations on the databases, okay? So every application has a database, right? Let's say this is your laptop. In your laptop, you opened one website, okay? In one of the browser, you opened a website. Let's say you opened this website like, tutorialsninja.com/demo, let's say. Fine, you opened this application in this laptop. Fine. When you open this application will communicate with the server, right? This application that is opened in your laptop will communicate with the server. Whenever you perform some operations on this particular Tutorials Ninja application, this application that you opened in the browser will communicate with its server. Okay. Tutorials Ninja will have its own application server. It will be hosted somewhere in a remote place. Okay. Application server will be there. So whatever this application is asking, the server will process. But every time, guys, okay, but there are some situations where, okay, there are some situations where, let's say you are registering an account here, okay? Let's say you are creating an account. From this application, you are creating an account. This request will be sent to the server. Where does this account details will be? Once the account is created, let's say using this functionality, you created an account. Now, where this particular account details will be created, will be stored, this application server, okay, will have a database. Okay, behind this application server, there will be a database. In this database, the server will store the details. If from your laptop, okay, just need to understand this, guys. From your laptop, okay, from your laptop, you created an account. Created an account by registering a new account. You created an account. So this request, all the details that you have used while creating an account will be sent to the server. Server will process that and server will simply store those details. Okay, newly account created details in the database, guys. This is how the database will look like. Okay, this is a database. In this database, all the details that were used for creating the account will be stored. Okay, so this is now guys, what is the purpose of SQL? Using SQL, we can query this database, guys, okay? Using this structured query language, as the name says, structured query language. So SQL has a list of queries, okay? There are list of queries in SQL. Using these queries, we can access this database directly, okay? In fact, this application and application server will use the same queries to access this database, okay? This application or application server will use the same queries of SQL to query this database. We can also use this SQL queries to access this database. Now, hope you understood what is this SQL now, right? SQL is a structured query language. It has a lot of queries using which we can access this particular database, access the data that is stored in the database. Fine. So now, as you have understood some high level, okay, about what exactly is SQL, okay, and why it is used for. There are a lot of operations, guys, okay? Using this SQL queries, you can perform a lot of operations, okay? Using this SQL queries. These queries are nothing but the SQL queries, guys, okay? These are nothing but the SQL queries. Using this SQL queries, we can perform a lot of operations on the database. Like we can actually, in fact, create a database. We can create a database. We can create a table, okay? We can insert data into the table. We can delete the data, okay? We can store the data. We can delete the data. We can update the data. We can delete the database itself. Lot of operations, guys. Okay, lot of operations are there, okay, which I cannot cover here. But at the high level, guys, this data can be modified, updated, deleted, added. Okay, anything can be done using this SQL queries. Hope you got some high level knowledge of this SQL, okay, and what exactly the SQL queries will do. Okay, in order to understand this SQL injection vulnerability, we have to learn this SQL basics, guys, okay, which consists of the SQL queries only, which can be used for querying the database for performing different operations like adding, deleting, updating the data. Fine. Now guys, let me take you to a particular website, okay? So this is the page you can see here. I'll copy this from qafox.com/sqlbasics. You can open this, guys, somewhere in the browser. And here are the SQL basics, guys, that you have to learn as part of the security testing, where you have to understand this. In order to understand that SQL injection vulnerability of the security testing, in order to understand this SQL injection vulnerability of the security testing, we have to have this SQL basic knowledge. So I already explained what is SQL, right? All these actions can be done with the help of this structured query language. Okay, using the queries of this structured query language, that is SQL, we can perform all these operations. We can retrieve the data, we can get the data, we can insert the data, we can update the data, we can delete the records, we can create new database, create new table, and many more, guys. Okay, I cannot cover all these things here. So here are the SQL commands or queries, guys. Here are the list of commands or queries. Let me demonstrate few queries, SQL queries, to you. Okay, so here is a website, a link is there, open in new tab. So from this page, you can go to this page, guys. Okay, here is a link, you can use this to go to here. This is a kind of here you can practice all your SQL. Okay, if you don't have much knowledge on SQL, you can practice writing the SQL queries here. So the basic step here is, like, once you go to this page, simply say restore database once. Okay, only one time you can do, then that's fine, guys. Okay, after that, here a lot of tables are there. Okay, it is a database, guys. Okay, there is a database. In the database, there are a lot of tables. These are all the examples of the tables, guys. Customers table, categories table. In this database, in this database provided by this w3schools.com, there are a lot of tables, like customers table, categories table, employees table, order details table, orders, products, shippers, suppliers. Okay, now guys, what we can do here is, from this customers table, I want to retrieve all the records. Okay, I want to retrieve all these 91 records from the customers table. So for that, there is a SQL query. Select star from, okay, star means all columns. Select star from, what is the table name? Customers. From the customers table, you want to get all the records, okay, all the data. This is for retrieving, guys. Here there is some line, right? Using this SQL queries, we can retrieve the data from the database. So from this database provided by the w3schools.com, okay, in one of the table, customers table, there is some data, guys. We are retrieving the data, okay, which is there in the customers table of this particular database. Now when you say select star from customers and run it, you see all the 91 records came. All the 91 records came, right? So all the 91 records that are there in the customers table are displayed here. Now, like, SQL queries are like, you can actually customize them, okay? So let's say I don't want all these 91 records, but I only want the records from this customers table, which are from this country, Germany, okay? Let's say this customer ID one is from, this customer one is from Germany, second customer is from Mexico. So some sixth customer is from Germany. I only want the records of the customers who are from Germany only, okay, country Germany. So what you have to do? Here we'll say where country is equal to Germany, okay? Germany, like this you have to say, and run this. You see, total 11 records came. Out of that 91 records, 11 records are of the customers who are from the country Germany, guys. So like this, guys, this is an example, guys. I am not going to explain you the complete SQL here, okay? I am not going to explain all the SQL queries here, okay? That will deviate the topic, okay? We are currently in the security testing video series, not SQL video series, right? So this is just a sample, okay? One or two queries I wanted to show you. So this is an example of the SQL query. So what this SQL query is doing, this SQL query is querying the database, okay? What is the purpose of this SQL query querying the database? Different purposes, guys. We can retrieve the data from the database. Whatever the example I showed you is for retrieving, for getting the data from the database, okay? For getting the data from the database, this particular query is used for, right? Similarly, there are SQL queries which can insert the data, okay? Here 91 records are there. You can insert few more records into the table. Like, you can add, like, along with this 91, you can add two or three more, like 92, 93, 94 records, okay? updating the data. You can update the details. You can change the customer details. Let's say first customer is from country Germany. You can change the country name to other country like India or something. Okay, like that you can do. So deleting the records. So here some record you can delete from this table. It has 91 records. You can delete few of the records. Like you can make it. You can delete 5 or 6 records so that it will become 85 records. Okay. So creating new databases. So here, guys, this particular database is created by W3 Schools. We don't have that control, okay? But if you want to really create a database, guys, you need to set up a lot of stuff, okay? So this tool will not help you in creating the databases. So we have to only work with the databases that, tables that this particular or database that this particular application is providing. But we don't have the control on this particular application at w3schools.com to create such kind of new databases. But using SQL, guys, we can even create the database. Here, database creation is not in our hands, but using SQL, there are some queries in SQL which can be used for creating the databases, guys. Okay. So, but you don't have to learn up to that mark. Okay. This will be enough, guys. Okay. This retrieving the data, inserting the new data, updating the data, deleting the records in the table. Okay. That will be enough. You don't have to alter the database and all. But having the knowledge is good. Okay. Having the knowledge of how to create the data is good. So get some basic knowledge, guys, of just a kind of feel of how the SQL queries are run and what's the purpose and all those stuff. That will be enough. Okay. So I already explained some examples like for SQL queries, right? So this kind of queries you should be able to write on the fly, guys. Then you'll be in a good position to move to the next topic, that is SQL injection vulnerability. Okay. In order to understand this SQL injection vulnerability, you should have this SQL basic knowledge. Fine. So here this documentation has a lot of okay, you can practice a lot from this documentation, guys. So here you see all the things are explained, like okay. So you can a lot of headings, you can go with this. First query is this one. Select command, I explained. Select star from table name. Okay, you can try that. Then after that, another example. Select column names. Okay, you can try this example. Select customer name, comma city from customers. You can try this. Then you can practice this statement. Select this particular column from this something something kind of thing. Yeah, a lot of examples are there here, as you can see. Okay, equal operator, less than operator, greater than operator, less than or equal to. You can try all these operators, between operators, okay, like operator, not like, in operator, and operator. How to use all these operators in the SQL queries, you have to learn, guys, okay? Or not operator, order by, how to use this order by. A lot of examples are provided already in this article. You can just practice on this particular, okay, page, so that you can get the results. Insert into, how to use insert into, how to what all about null values, okay, null values, and some functions are also there regarding this null values. Then we have update command, okay. Then we have delete command, we have top class, we have limit class, we have minimum and maximum functions, we have other count, average, and some functions, wildcards. Lot of knowledge, guys, okay. Lot of knowledge you can learn from this article, okay. Wildcards, how to use the wildcards. So if you have a lot of time, guys, you can complete all these queries, okay? So SQL joins, regarding joins also, there are a lot of examples here. Inner join, left join, outer join, okay? Right join, full outer join, self join. This operators like union, group by, group, okay? A lot of things, okay? I'm just walking you through, guys, okay? I'm not explaining anything. So if you have, like, just gain some knowledge about the databases also, guys, even though you cannot practice this create database command or query in this particular page, but at least having this knowledge is enough, okay? If you have to create databases, if you have that complete control of the storage, then you can actually even create the databases also. You can drop the databases. That means dropping means deleting the database. You can create the table inside the databases. You can drop the tables, delete the tables in the databases. A lot of other things, guys, okay? All these things, if you can practice, guys, how much you can practice, that is that much you'll be good, guys, okay? If you have to understand the SQL injection in a detailed manner, then you have to practice all this SQL basics, guys. There is no other way. Okay, a lot of stuff is there. Okay, if you can cover all this SQL basics from this article, that will be enough for you to understand this SQL injection, guys. So initially, if you don't want to spend so much time on this article, guys, just learn few of these things. Okay, just get a feel of what exactly the SQL queries and all those stuff. Okay, only practice few SQL commands. Then you can move to the next session. Later when you have time, you can complete this article. So this is the plan, guys, okay? You can go with that plan so that it will, in the future, right, you can increase your knowledge in SQL basics so that you can work full-fledgedly with this SQL injection vulnerability. So hope, guys, you understood this session and you got to know what you have to learn, right? I have walked you through the list of SQL basics that you have to learn for understanding this SQL injection in detail, guys. Okay, if you want to go to the SQL injection at the advanced level, then you have to learn all these SQL basics, guys. Okay, for getting started with SQL injections, you don't have to learn the complete list, but at least, okay, but if you want in tomorrow, if you want to understand this SQL injection at advanced level, then you have to learn all the SQL basics, guys. There is no other way. So that's all about this session, guys. See you in the next session. Thank you. Bye.